Good evening to all of you present over here. So this is Suraj Pa once again come back with the different talks, which is talks which is forwarded from the Go Ahead Hub technology. So here the talks which is forwarded. So first of all, what's the having supervised machine learning over there? So it is basically like there is a having label data, and after the label data we just pass it towards having modeling of the training. So we have to just predict whether this means label, for example, this is like square, rectangles and hexagonals, which is present elements. After that, we have to just predict whether whatever the component which is from the tested, so whether it should be square or like rectangle or like hexagonal. So this is known as a supervised machine learning algorithms. So in this, so after that, it should be provided like there is given data set from this. And so here is the theory which is provided, whatever the things I already mentioned over there, which is explained by the having the showing with the diagram. So in this data set, so we have to just given over algorithms. So first of all, we have just input the libraries which is having NumPy, Pandas, Matplotlib and Seaborn. After it, we have just using the Google Collabs, which is having the Google Drive, which is having the mounted over our data. So for that we are using this command. After that part, which is what in which part our data means our data set which is already which is stored over there. So that's why we are just given the path. And after that we have just pd.read_csv for part plus this means data set name which is provided to us, that having the student harscore.csv file. Then we have just deemed the having type. What the type of our data set, this is like having panda data frame which is having the type. After that we have just find the having what the shape of our data set. We have to find that df.head means from top 5 rows, and after that tail means bottom 5 rows. After that we have this correlations between the having the R feature which is having like hars and score. We have just correlation between them. After that, what are the names of our columns? So that's why we are using the df.column. After that, we have just find the mean and maximum value. So based on the df.min and max function, automatically we are just using. Then after that, we have to, if you want to find that what are the unique values which is present on our given data set. So that's why we are using df.unique. There is a function which is used. And after that, if you want to like particular data set only, we want not the whole data set. So for that we are using the iloc means iloc function which is used. After that, for the statistical information, for example mean, max, count, then 25%, 30, it's all means all derivations which is provided, which is given by the df.describe. Then after that, the information of the whole data set means what the actual value of that means data sets, what type of is there is a null value or not, so what type of how much memory. So that's why info function which is used. So it's check whether is null or dot sum which is represent or not, is there or not. So there is a no duplicate value, so that's why we are using 00 which is given from this. After that we have just like what are the means in this supervised machine learning model we are using with having simple linear regression. So simple linear regression means there is only one dependent and one independent value. So independent is like x and dependent is y. So for that we are just printing x and y. So after that we are just using the splitting the data set by using the trust and train data. So that's why we are using scikit-learn. So scikit-learn lot having model selection for train test split. After that we have just put it x, y and test size like a 0.2. I just put it it's depend on you as per like 0.25 or all the things. So random state I just put it is 1. So after that we have just printed the shape and this. After that we have just using the our model name is like linear regression. So from model equals to linear regression we have to just fit the model, and after that fitting the model we are just predict based on the x test. So we are just our the result which is come like that. So after that we are just finding that what is actual and the predicted value. So if there is actual value is 40, so predicted value which is come over like 40.87. So after that, we are just finding the mean square value, so mean square error. So that's why we are using the scikit-learn matrix with important mean square and R2 scores. If you want like R2 scores, so you may be having just qualified over there. After that, we are just finding the slope. So y slope for that is m equals to modulus coefficients. So as you know, that slope formula is y equals to mx plus c. So we have just find the intercept is c and like this. So y equals to mx plus c. So x is value, for example, if the student which is having study for only like 5.9 hours. So we have just calculate our roughly sketch what's the value. So in this beyond, we have just get it that what actual value which is given by this. This, so we have just plotted, so x train, y train with having red color which is represent. So we have just spread with x train, so that's why we are the line which is provided to us, which is given. And after that, we are having training by having x train and x test. So what they having actually the plotted or this whatever the having dots which is comes towards with a predicted lines. So if you having for this which is represent, so like having 5.9 hours, so here which is covered like 5.9, so the score which is having this which is mentioned. So yeah, thank you so much.